It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1573, recorded on Thursday, June 2nd, 2016. Stop bugging me! On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we got some gadgets that you can't pass up and some that'll keep those pests away, and the first of my new themed month, all next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
under pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the maestro of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How are you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing good, sir, and you?
Perfect. I'm doing well myself. I'm doing well myself.
Good.
Yeah, it's been a good week, God, it feels like Thursday is always kind of the Giz is actually the start of the end of my week, I have to say. So, we're here!
Yes, we are.
TGIT. Thank God it's Thursday.
Thursday. Okay. No, that's good. That's good.
How was your week?
My week was good. You know, it's so funny that this guy called. If he had called 10 minutes later, I just got the Microsoft call. Hello, this is Microsoft Tech, and there's something wrong with your computer.
Oh, gosh. And a scam call.
I know. I said, oh, hang on. You'll be the next caller. And he said, what?
What?
I said,
you called into a radio show.
He said, what do you mean? I said, it's a radio show and you're going to be on. So talk real loud. Ladies and gentlemen, let's go to caller number 10. Click dial tongue.
Good way. Good way to get rid of him. Oh, my gosh.
I know.
Hello, this is Microsoft. We've realized that your credit card isn't up to date with our systems. If you could please just read that credit card number to me.
Exactly.
Good to go. Okay. Exactly. You know, we look up your information based off of social security number. So if you could just give me your social security number and your address, that would be fantastic, sir. Thank you. Oh, who am I talking to again?
You know, did you see that reporter? He was at like a hackers convention. And he sat down and this.
Oh, yes. She got his information in minutes.
Yes. She got into his phone account, changed the password, added her name, and it was 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And the guy said, so basically, I'm locked out of my own account and you're now in control of it.
Uh-huh.
And she said, yeah. She said, right after this, you should go back, call them up and tell them change it all back.
And then and then he has trouble doing that because he doesn't have the right credentials. No, I'm just kidding.
No. But I mean that they're so cunning. I mean, she had a tape recording of
a
crying baby.
Yes.
And she, you know, made it sound like she was harassed and I need help and
that type of hacking is called social engineering. And you prey on people's weaknesses to help other people or to misunderstand a situation or to assume something that isn't even stated and for them to help you out and to get around layers of security. It's very frustrating because the only thing you can't really do anything. The phone company needs your information. They need your home address, but they're not secure enough to keep it. To keep it to themselves. I know other YouTubers who have had their information compromised and people will post it online and normally they say who gave it to them and it's normally a cable company, a phone company, or one of those utilities that leaks their information using these means. Yes, it's very frustrating. Very frustrating.
Interesting. You know, I did have I'm always trashing Time Warner, and I have this thing now. It's called the Signature Home. I'm a Signature Home customer.
Oh, Signature. Nice.
Yes.
Ooh, that's like having the black card.
It is, because Dennis and I, we have this thing where you record on any cable box, and every other cable box sees it. So when there's trouble, they give you a real person immediately.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, and right before yesterday, I always check, you know, the speedtest.com. Suddenly, my upload speed had gone from 24 to 6. So whoa. I called the guy up and I said, I unplugged the router, I rebooted the computer, I've done all that. And he said, oh, let me take a look here. So he says, oh, my God, that signal is awful. He said, you know what? I think the splitter is defective. And I said, where are you? He said, I'm in San Diego. I said, you can tell from San Diego that the splitter is defective. And he said, well, do you have a couple minutes? Can we try it? Can you just take the inline out of the back of the splitter and put it directly to your router? And I said, I can do that. And I did that. And I went from 6 megabits back to 24 megabits.
Wow, he knew. This guy is a pro.
I know. And he said, you know what? You can either run to your local hardware store or a Home Depot. I said, well, there's a Time Warner store 14 blocks from here. And he said, okay, just go up there. I already put in your record that you need a splitter. So I went up there. And there must be 50 people waiting. But fortunately, there's a person at the door who says, what are you here for? And I said, I need a splitter. And the person said, just a splitter? And I said, yes. She said, hang on, I'll hand you one.
Wow.
I know.
How often does that happen? Well, thanks,
I know.
Time
so
Warner.
I was between the time I called to the time it was solved with the new splitter was a little less than an hour.
Wow.
Yeah. Meanwhile, Dennis's Verizon phone has been out for a month. and the strike is over, and the earliest they can come is a week from tomorrow.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh.
At no specific time.
That is so frustrating.
Yeah.
That is so frustrating. I got to say that my current internet service provider has been really good. I don't want to say who it is because I'm afraid of that leaking information stuff, but they've been really good, and part of me wonders if they looked at my Twitter account and was like, oh, he has a lot of followers. Whenever he calls, we need to up him to a better tier of service.
Like, that, you know what?
That doesn't seem stupid. That seems like something that a company would do. I wonder if I'm getting the same. It's been so good. I've been wondering, are you guys spying on my Twitter account? Do you guys realize who I am?
Well, you know what? Did you put their name in any tweets? You didn't, right?
I direct messaged them a few times.
Oh, okay. That could be. I mean, I had a thing at United Airlines. We were all on the plane. I had used 50,000 miles to go first class. They sat everybody down. They served everybody drinks and then announced that there was no pilot. And that the pilot was, this is from the Vegas back from the hardware show, and that the pilot was indeed still in Los Angeles.
And you guys were actually in the air at that point. That's crazy.
Yes. I said, you know, I saw Airplane, the movie. Give me a shot at it. Anyway, I tweeted it because I was so PO'd. And I got a tweet back from at United. It said, if there's anything we can do, we're nowhere near where you are, but we feel bad for you. And I just said, well, I'm even impressed that you.
Yeah. You sent me a tweet back.
That you read tweets that say at United.
So yeah. Yeah, I know. There has been more than one time that I have gotten better service by going to Twitter. And I always feel really bad about it because I do have more followers than other people. And so I assume that I get a better level of service because of my Twitter followers. But on the same token, I've seen my own friends who have a normal amount, you know, like under 100 or around 100. And they get good service. They get responses back, too. So I've been impressed by companies that use Twitter in, as another form. You don't always have to pick up the phone and call them. You can just tweet at them and get a response. So, absolutely. Yeah.
There is some use for social media.
Yes, absolutely. More than sandwich pictures. Let's jump into some gadgets.
Okay, we're going to jump into some three Amazon gadgets that are all under $20. So any vague idea what this little guy might be here? Chat room, can jump in.
Digital thermometer. It's a keychain. No, definitely.
No. I will give it partly away when I do that.
There's USB. That looks like a micro USB port on the bottom there. So it has to be for a phone, huh? Is it, It's a USB thumb drive, so some people.
In a way, this, somebody did get it. Twisted Echoes. This is a on-the-go drive from SanDisk. So most, a lot of the new Android devices, I know my all three Galaxies that I have OTG technology in them. And so basically, this is a little USB 3 drive, and this one is 32 megabytes. And so you plug this into a, megabytes. I'm sorry, gigabytes.
Yeah, I was like, wait, that has got to be the smallest amount that they ever. But okay, I mean, we're going to take a quick tangent. I had to go buy a hard drive today, and I went to Best Buy. The smallest size hard drive they have is 1 terabyte.
Oh my gosh.
That is the smallest size they have. So you saying megabytes, I was like, there's no they are selling something that small. A terabyte is the smallest external hard drive.
And how much is a 1 terabyte hard drive?
$60.
Oh my gosh.
$60 for a terabyte. Yeah. That's great. The thing is I'm doing it because I have a big project. It has 150 gigabytes of footage in it, and I need to, it's just too much to upload and download. So I'm putting it on a hard drive and mailing the hard drive. So I was walking in expecting to get a 256 gigabyte hard drive. Nope. The only thing I could get was a terabyte. So
wow.
I thought that was pretty crazy. Pretty crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, so okay, so it's 32 gigabytes, so it has the micro USB on that end, and you put it in, your phone sees it as another drive, you download movies, whatever you want to it, and then this end has a standard USB drive, and so you can then upload it to any sort of computer, Mac or PC. And the reason I was happy about this is, for the Giz Wiz videos, we use a Galaxy S6, which does not have an expansion SD card slot. And every once in a while, if you're at a big event, you can fill the memory in the phone. And this way, instead of having to go someplace and go through all the videos and see which ones I really don't want, just download them to this little guy and off the phone, and then you freed up the memory on the phone. And you talk about your, so how much do you think this little drive was? So it's 32 gigabytes.
I would assume, because it's a newer technology, it costs a little more. By the way, I don't know. I would hope that it's in the $20 to $30 range, is what I would hope.
Well, okay, Chad, this was $11.
Oh, that's great. That is good. Okay.
And if you want to really spend some bucks, there's a 64 gigabyte version that is like $17.90.
That's good. That's good.
These are really amazing. Now, I'll give you a little time-saving tip. The instructions that come with it say, go to Google Play, and download our Memory Zone app. Okay, so that was the first thing I did. And then I put the drive in, and I used the Memory Zone app, and I checked all the things I wanted to move off the Galaxy phone. And then I said, send to the little USB 3.0 drive. And it said, please connect drive. Well, I said, no. The drive, see that? Look down. The drive is already connected. It would not see this drive. So I called SanDisk, only on the phone for about 2 minutes. And I got a guy who said, are you using our app? I said, yes. He said, don't use the app.
Our app is a piece of crap. I mean, it's really bad.
He didn't say that. He said, just don't use the app. He said, it works perfect if you just drag and drop and leave the app out of it. So I did that. I actually erased the app, and it works perfectly. isn't that funny?
That's bad. That's bad.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's only on Galaxies because I think the app lets you do some other things. But I thought, what a great little device for so little money.
Yeah.
32 gigabytes was, I think, $10.97, and 64 gigabytes is under $18, both on Amazon.
Wow, that's great. And there's a little video from SanDisk. Should we watch that?
Oh, yeah. Actually, it's a little 30-second video that sort of
explains.
Does a cutesy pie.
Yeah. Down to town, down to town. Look at our app that doesn't work. Now.
Oh, yeah, cool, a lot of people with both. Tablets.
Yeah, exactly.
Tablets.
It looks just like that when you plug it in. It sucks all your movies directly into it. That's a pretty cool little feature that it has both. It has both USB sticks so that you don't have to get a few different ones.
No, nice. I think it's really great.
Yeah, and good price, and available on Amazon.
On Amazon, SanDisk. Ultra dual USB drive.
Oh, you can even get a 16 gigabyte one for $8. Look at that.
That is a riot.
That's great.
Yeah. Well, you know, for $3 more, why not get double the memory?
Yeah, seriously.
That is a riot.
Seriously. Wow, that's a nice little device. I like it. Yeah. And your phone does have to be OTG or on the go compatible. So
exactly. And over at SanDisk, just look for the compatibility page, and it will list all the gadgets that have that. But pretty much all the later things. I know in the reviews, a lot of people were using this on tablets too.
Right. Right. Perfect. Well, that's a great little gadget. I like it. So what's your next gadget?
All right, second gadget, also from Amazon, also under $20. So I use an Acer S7 to do our show here. And I don't know, are you familiar with the Acer S7? It's one of those.
It's super thin. It's it's an ultra book.
Exactly. It's, you know, you have to put a paperweight on it or it will drift up.
It's a beautiful laptop. It is... it has amazing glass top. It has amazing edges. Yeah, I love the look of it.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
And the slight problem with all of these is that they usually just have, some have just one USB port. This one has two USB ports. But the problem is if you want to use hardwired Wi-Fi, then you need a USB adapter, so that takes up one USB port. And then for a guest, I run a USB monitor, so that takes up the other USB port. And then I like to add on a mouse, and sometimes I use an external keyboard so I can be using the monitor further away. Anyway, I wanted a way to add USB. And, you know, I could use a hub, but I'm thinking, what if someone made a hub that also lets you add a hardwired Ethernet cable? So I go to Amazon and I find something from a company called Inatec. So the Inatec, there it is right there. So it is three port.
USB 3.
USB 3.0,
and
exactly.
That's gigabit internet. That's I think you can get, I mean, you can obviously buy whatever you want for thousands of dollars. But for the home use, gigabit is basically what you're ever going to use.
Exactly.
That's great.
And this guy was under $20.
That's fantastic.
And it comes with about 11 inches of cable. So that goes into USB. Then I hook up the router directly to that. Then I have three USB, three ports. And like I said, $19.95. And it got pretty good reviews.
Yeah,
I'm looking
good
there
reviews.
As you pinned them. The only problem is, this afternoon, I was saying, let me go back in there and just make sure the price is still under $20. And I stumble upon a better model.
Oh, no. This one?
From the same company, because the downside of the one I bought, it doesn't bother me much, but it doesn't have the transmit receive LED lights that a lot of them have. So you have to look at your laptop to see that you're transmitting and receiving. And then I see a new aluminum version.
All aluminum. And that matches your Acer S7.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. Mm. For a whopping
$5
more.
Yeah.
So I thought, oh my God.
Well, now probably, is it within time? Can you still return the older one?
Yeah, you know what? I'm very late. Have you ever returned things?
Barely ever.
Me either.
Barely
I mean, the
ever.
Thing is, you know, your time isn't worth $20 to find a box
and I don't even know, please generate me a return label and
so I'm just gonna have a spare.
Yeah, exactly. You know, that's not bad. It's funny, I actually bought something very similar. I got the MacBook. It's the thinnest, it's thinner than the Apple Air. I got the MacBook like a year and a half ago, something like that, when it first came out. And I love that computer. All day I'm sitting in front of a desktop, and whenever I went to a laptop, I'm not really doing really heavy stuff. I'm not editing. I'm editing that on my desktop. I'm not really, gaming. I do that on my desktop. So all I was doing was browsing the internet and replying to emails. And so I bought this MacBook, fantastic computer. It's a little slow, but same thing. It has one USB Type-C port. And whenever whenever I went to a hotel or whenever I was out and about or needed to upload something fast, I wanted that Ethernet cable and I wanted some extra USB ports. Same. I found something very similar that had USB-C on the other end instead of just normal USB. So yeah, I found something very similar. It's great that they have these available in the market. So do you have both now, or do you have both of them?
No, I haven't got the new one, because the new one I found out about just about an hour ago.
Oh, gosh.
right before the show, let me just go in there and sign in into tech and see if it's still $20. And then I say, wait a minute, I'm on an Intertech page, but it says aluminum. Whoa, no, it says lights. Someone's saying, wouldn't the flash drive have lights in them? The flash drives do, but I'm talking about the transmit receive little LEDs.
Yeah, to make sure that the other side is plugged in and everything's going through.
Exactly.
It's the little yellow and green lights next to the Ethernet cable.
Exactly.
Yeah.
My current one doesn't have it, but the fact that we're talking to each other pretty much guarantees that
something's working. Either that, you know, or your Wi-Fi has just been great. I mean, just fantastic.
You know, maybe you know the answer to this. I was having a lot of trouble early with buffering and my screen freezing, and this happens on Twitter a lot. Why is it that you can have a totally crappy connection and then you hang up and you call right back, and then it's a great connection?
I would say that it's algorithms. You know, there's so many factors that it's hard to say. But in terms of Skype, what I suspect is that Skype, in order to make sure to limit bandwidth and to try to give a good quality call that doesn't drop, which would be a complete failure, they have algorithms to see your speed. So if for some reason there's maybe a bump in your network, and the throughput has been throttled a lot, Skype might remember that and not try to go above where it was, because if it tries, it might cause the call to fail a lot more. So I assume that it's something in Skype is telling it, you know, oh, I'm not going to use any more band. Well, you know, it screwed up once. I'm not going to try anymore.
See, Skype was looking at my numbers when the splitter was out.
Exactly. It still remembers.
And now someone at Skype happened to be listening to the podcast.
Exactly.
And said, oh.
Oh, we'll clear that up for him.
Yeah, let me just do.
There we go.
Okay, so gadget number two, under $20. And now gadget number three for under $20. It's getting to be warm, getting to be nice. Flowers in the yard are blooming. Trees are growing green.
Spring is almost over.
Spring. And the bugs are back. And I hate bugs, and I'm one of those people who 30 people can go out, and I will be the one the most mosquitoes decide to munch on.
I think that it is a skin surface area. See, my head is covered. There you go.
Yeah. The only thing is you attract the rare strain of bull mosquitoes who are attracted to red.
Red
moving objects.
Exactly.
So what's very funny about the timing of this is that I have packed away somewhere a Floatron insect killer, and these are big guys. And the warehouse video, the guy is going to talk and show us a Floatron. In the meantime, I go back to Amazon and said, let me see if there's something more demure for the backyard. And I found this. So let's look at that.
Dick DeBartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. It's midnight, and we're out in the backyard looking for mosquitoes, because this is the 2-in-1 mosquito killing light bulb. Okay, it's a big bulb, as you can see here, and so you may have trouble finding a fixture that it fits in. We just got a bare socket and wired it to an on-off switch and screwed the bulb into that. And I'll show you why it's called the 2-in-1 light bulb. This is in the bug mode. Now, when you turn it off and turn it back on,
oh wow!
You'll see that two lights came on. An LED light down here that's about the equivalent of a 75-watt bulb, and the little bug light stayed on. Now, if you turn it off and then on again, that shuts off the LED and turns on the bug light. So you don't need a special switch. Any on-off switch will...
That is a great mechanism.
...between bug light and the LED light. It seems as that even if you're using the LED light, the little bug light will stay on. But it's no big deal because the bug light is 1 watt. Now, originally, I thought this was a joke because I had it out here for 5 hours and it did nothing. And now, about 7 hours later, I see a dead mosquito.
One dead mosquito.
I don't know if that qualifies as a bug killer, but it did something. This is $20 on Amazon, and it's called the 2-in-1 Mosquito Killer Bowl. Dick DeBartolo, Maz Medist Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
So, would you say that it doesn't do a very good job killing the bugs?
When you see the Floatron in our gadget video of the week, you'll see what a real zapper is. But the thing is, can you go to their page, Chad? I think it got really excellent reviews.
Yeah, on Amazon.
On Amazon. And...
yeah, 17 reviews, 4.5 stars.
Stars. Oh, it went up in price.
Oh, it's $21. Darn it.
$22.
We can check Camelizer here, and we can confirm that it was down in the $20 range moments before the show started.
Yes, isn't that a riot?
Oh,
the same guy who watches my Skype.
Also, make sure Skype to change the Amazon prices. Yes.
Also, right. Exactly. And if you go back up, you'll see in the ad that it is a pest. What do they have it advertised as?
Pest blast bulb.
Yes, pet blast. But when you get the bulb, it's like it is in the picture. There are no markings on it whatsoever. And I have an idea that it's marketed as many different kinds of bulbs.
Yeah, it seems like a Chinese manufacturer might be making this and sending them all around.
Exactly. Oh, you know, go back to the box. There you go. Go back to the other picture. See, that one has Pet Blast on it. See, at the top of the bulb.
Oh, I see, yeah, right there.
And there, exactly. But when you get the bulb, there are no markings on it whatsoever.
Yeah,
and it does come with a tiny little brush.
Oh, to wipe away the mosquitoes?
To wipe away the mosquitoes.
Right.
If they ever, if you ever get that many.
It might take a few weeks.
A few weeks, right. You know, the deluxe model comes with 100 dead mosquitoes.
Oh, that's great. Oh, so you can show off to your friends that
it works.
Yeah, you
can just say, God, is this thing amazing?
Exactly. Keeping up with the Joneses, the mosquito killers.
Yeah. But that little on-off thing is clever, isn't it?
I think that is the coolest feature of this, is that you can have two modes and keep your same switches. You don't have to reach up to the bulb. I think that's fantastic. I really
You have
really
to do
like
it
that.
Quick. You have to do it within 3 seconds so that
that's
the bulb,
what you would do if you were going to switch a
no,
mode.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
It's like double tapping almost. I like that a lot, actually. And yeah, around $20, you know, hey, if you don't have a big pest problem, this is probably the bulb for you.
Yes, exactly. And again, in the backyard or something, you may like it that there's a bulb in there too, so that while if you're eating out, you actually have the one fixture that can light the dinner table.
Right.
And then when you go in, just click that off, and now you have the bug light. So you only need one plug for the two-way fixture. I think that's a good thing. And now, as you heard, it is now
$22. Sorry, our $20. It's broken.
Yes, broken. Exactly.
Okay.
Okay, well now, Chad, it's June.
It is.
So I don't even know what your theme is.
Oh, I'll tell you here. Let's jump back here.
Chad, Crappy Corner.
It's Crappy
Corner. And now, along with you, we'll find out what the Patreons decided.
Okay, yeah, so you can kind of see a little bit of it. We're not hiding it very well here. There we go. Now you don't know. We asked the patrons over on Patreon, and the ideas, the three categories were water, Bluetooth, and science. So those were the things that they had to choose from, and the winner happened to be science. So this month's theme is science. Here, let me go see if I can find my post that we can see the results from our Patreon. Here we go. And here it is. Opening that up. And here are our results. And there we go. Over 51% of you thought science was what we should do.
Giz
Wiz has blinded you with science. So I went and got a few science things. And the first two things we have discussed on the podcast before, that Star Wars has taken over. So, yes. I have two science-y Star Wars gadgets here that I wanted to show off. And the first one actually requires a little bit of time. It, in fact, requires over a week of time. So, we're going to start it in this show, and then we'll show off the results in the next show. And the idea of this is that you're going to be building your own crystals.
Nuclear reactor.
Exactly, right. Nuclear reactor to power a lightsaber. Inside of lightsabers in the mythical world of Star Wars, there are crystals that focus the beam to create a lightsaber. So this kit is to make your own crystals inside of this little kit. So I've already gone ahead and taken the liberty to read the instructions. I know that's not normally how the Giz Wiz operates. But don't worry, I've already done it. So the first step is to unpackage, obviously, the product. And you're given some of the crystal grow material. You're given this, which is a little bucket to grow the crystals in. And then you're given a stir stick and a base. And later, you will be using this base. You'll add batteries to it, and this base will turn on and will allow your crystals to grow. Well, hopefully it'll turn on. There we go. That switch. So it'll allow your crystals to grow.
You mean it grows by light?
It grow. No, no. Sorry, glow, not grow.
Oh, glow.
Glow.
Oh, okay.
Glow. So I have a measuring cup here and a hot water. The first step was to boil some water, and my water is actually still steaming here. So we're doing okay. Pretty good here. We're gonna bring in 1 2/3 cups here, and that is this line right here. Man, you can see this is steaming quite a bit.
Yeah.
Holy mackerel. Okay, so we brought that up to the line, and then we take our crystal growing solution, mm-hmm. Ooh la la, which is bag A, and we are going to place that into...
It seems like you have everything dangerously close to your keyboard.
That's how we do it. Here on the Giz Wiz, oh my gosh, hopefully I can open up this package. Not sure if I have any other solution for this. I'm going to get grow crystals all over the set here if I... yeah. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this...
That's packaged like those little cheese blocks they give you on an airplane.
Oh my gosh.
Which is like so ridiculous because you're starving and you cannot get it open.
I can't get this open at all.
All right,
Do I have any?
How far away is a knife or a scissors?
I think it might be downstairs.
Okay.
This is the closest option that that I have here. I'm not gosh. Apparently I did a good enough job. I got crystals falling out here.
Okay, good.
We've started it. There we go.
Okay. Usually sometimes
on the
teeth
chair.
Work.
I don't know if this is toxic or not. I guess it's a child's thing. So, okay, so we got our crystals open. We're going to pour it into our solution there.
Ooh.
Okay, there we go. It comes with a stir stick, so we'll take this up and stir it all around. What we're trying to do is have this dissolve completely into this water. There are some instructions here in English and in Spanish. So, if you were wondering about this, this is a bilingual product here. This is what the instructions look like. Not too bad. Oh my gosh! The next step is to let it cool for 10 minutes.
Okay.
So we're gonna stir this up. Let's make sure that it gets dissolved, and then I'm gonna move on to my next gadget. I got two Star Wars. Gadgets here, so someone in the chat room might have to make this timer for 5 minutes, 10 minutes, sorry, here, or my phone, here, we'll get my phone. Set a timer, set a timer for 10 minutes.
Timer's already paused.
Pause? No, change it to 10 minutes.
The wonderful world of technology.
There we go. Okay. And also if you kick are right. it's mostly dissolved in here, which is
I heard your command chat and you will now go to prison for 10 years. Thank you.
Transferring top secret emails. There we go. Okay. So that's we're going to set that aside here and we'll get back to that in a little while. We may have to move on to the letter or such, if we don't have enough time for that. The next gadget, though, this I was really excited about because I've actually seen and played with this science experiment before. My wonderful grandmother at Christmas actually let us play with this, or a version of this. Hopefully I can pull this out of the... man, scissors may be required for all gadgets on the Giz Wiz moving forward. So, oh no. Oh my gosh, this is my biggest pet peeve. Any gadget that requires a screwdriver to open up the gadget.
Where's your open it?
Oh my gosh, where did it go? I got batteries installed. Anything that requires a screwdriver to open up batteries is always frustrating for me, but Dickie D was saying that that's a child protective feature. So, what you are getting is this wand here, and the wand has a motor inside which will cause sort of a static feedback. You can hear it running in there I hit the button inside right here on the bottom. So it's running. So that should I can feel it on my hair, although my hair is pretty stuck to my head, but you can see.
Oh no, it's lifting right off your head.
Yeah, there you go. So you can see that works on here. So the idea is there are these really small and thin foil. Here they are, foil toys, and you take these and you learn how to levitate them using the static electricity. And so there's a whole bunch here, and we just need one. So we'll pull this off the paper here. Whoop, and very light. And you run you push the button and you let it drop. And did you see that?
Yeah.
I'm not sure if you saw what happened there. It somehow catches the static electricity charge and becomes like inflated almost with charge and then can levitate.
Oh, look at that.
Isn't that cool? Isn't that neat? And so this is a fun little scientific toy, and you can kind of pump the static charge that's in the tube here. Oh, and there you go, stuck to the TV there. And they also give you different types of little foil things to play with. So you can, that was a kind of a small one. You can have some large ones here. Oh, I got it caught in the tape. I hope that doesn't destroy it here. Here's another one. This one,
ooh,
a lot larger here. It's actually more of like a double version of the one we just did. It's not broken apart, so we can drop it. And there you go.
Oh, look at that.
Isn't that fun? Isn't that really cool? And then, of course, you'll practice how well, you know, you get it to stay floating. They also have a single loop here. I don't think I've ever played with a single loop. No. Oh, there we go.
Look at that.
Got the loop to float up there.
It's a complete circle.
And so this is, you know, using Star Wars branding. And, you know, obviously it's kind of acting like you're using the Force here. To keep this floating and up. But I thought this was such a fun little gadget and toy to play with. Oh, wait, well, there goes that loop. It's gone forever. And it's kind of magical in its own little way. So anyway, so that is that's.
And
this.
What does that cost?
This one cost, let me find out, $15.
Actually,
$20.
Consumer version is $15. The government version is $55,000.
$55 million. Yes, exactly. And so these are quite fun to play with. And now I'm going to have foil everywhere, and then static charge all the time as well. So that's that.
And Chad, you can reuse them, right? Nothing's happening to them.
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah, okay. This is not. Now, these are the little paper things that comes with
it.
Oh,
I see.
You can get rid of that. But yeah, these can be, as long as you're delicate with them and you don't break them apart, you can store these and then use them again and again and again and recharge the battery and continue to use all of that. So yes, it does. It does continue. We'll pull off the static charge here off of. Off of your TV. Now, moving back to the the crystals. Sorry that we're kind of running all over the place. This has been allowed to cool for 10 minutes. Our timer is actually just about ready to go off here in 50 seconds. And the next step, let me just triple check, is to pour this, now that it's cooled, into the reservoir, which we'll be using to actually grow the crystals. So we're going to take this, pour this in, and the reason we allowed it to cool was so that it wouldn't just completely melt this thing. Oh my gosh. Right up to the edge there. Okay, so that's been poured in. And then we take the final bag. This is the blue crystal starter granules. And I assume this is going to work something like where it will start the crystal growing process and then we'll come back for quite a while. And these crystals will grow over the next 7 days. So we should be able to see this perfectly next Giz Wiz, because that'll be seven days from now.
I'm glad we're not doing two shows in a row.
Exactly. That would be embarrassing. So I'm going to actually move this over to its resting place, okay. Because one of the things is that you shouldn't move it too much, because it'll... Oh, that's my timer there. That's because if it moves too much, the crystals could fall apart. So we're going to add our crystal starters here.
So if we don't win an award, we'll at least have glowing crystals.
We'll at least have some glowing crystals.
Right.
There
Which
you
we'll
go.
Claim is an award. An
yeah,
intergalactic,
exactly. Yep.
The Intergalactic Best Tech Podcast Award.
We'll be starting our lightsaber business on the side any day now because of that. And then we take this little thing. And you do need to store it within, I believe it was 67 degrees Fahrenheit. So you don't want it to get or 68 degrees Fahrenheit. So you don't want it to get too cold. But also, you know, obviously not too warm. So we'll come back and see what those crystals do in 7 days. And that kit is the one
that costs
$70.
The chat room doesn't have to wait, right?
No, the chat, well.
No. Okay.
Yeah, I mean, people watching at home, you know, you might have to wait a little bit. So those are my science, the first of my science month here on the Giz Wiz. Once again, the cost of the static electricity wand, that was $20, and the crystal making kit was $15, and you can get those at Toys R Us or Amazon, depending on where you shop. So those are my crappy gadgets. Hope it was crappy enough for you guys. So yeah. Now let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
And our Gadget Warehouse video came with this email. Hi, Giz Wiz and OMG Chad. I remember this gadget growing up in the 80s. It seemed like everyone in the neighborhood had one. On a summer night, you could hear the sound of bugs frying from miles away, or it seemed that way. Buying a humane version of this product, I was disappointed. There was no zapping noise. I did some research and I found what I was looking for. Hope you enjoyed the video. Kevin Dieterage, Dieterage. And here's Kevin's video.
Hey, Giz Wiz and OMG Chad.
Hey, Kevin.
This is Kevin Dieterage. I've been waiting on it all day. And it's come. Here it is, folks. The Flotron Outdoor Insect
Killer. You
can
hear the zapping.
Or as we call them bug zappers here in Kentucky. Anyway, I've been waiting on this all day. It's amazing. Just plugged it in a couple hours ago. It's frying them like crazy. Let's check it out.
It's like a mad scientist.
I know.
There you can see.
You know what's funny? I think we had something exactly like this as a kid.
See if we can get a good one in there. For your viewing pleasure. There it is.
Jeez.
Oh, yeah. This one right here is the one you want. It's the one and one half acre model.
Wow. That's a lot of space.
It's attracted them like crazy. This is the one you want. You get good puff of smoke.
Okay, so
do
the one.
Do you smell anything, I wonder?
Great lighting
you
effects.
Do.
They just sizzle.
If a big bug goes in, you do smell them.
Ew, gross. Like
the humane ones that just. I bought a humane one that just. It wasn't worth it. Just. This is where it's at, right?
I love his passion.
This is the Floatron. Just in time for summer. So hopefully get another good zap in there. You'll love it. You'll love the smell.
We need to take a vote in the chat room. Would you guys rather have the humane or the zaptastic version?
Oh, God. This is what I do have, and I was thinking of trying to get something smaller. I wish there was something in between, because what I have seems to humor the bugs.
Yes.
Whereas that one fries them. I mean, the one that I have, the bug part is 1 watt, okay? The bug zapper that he has is 80 watts.
80 watts?
80 watts. So... However, I believe he's outdoors.
Yeah.
And it seemed like he had a lot of bugs around there, which the backyard, I don't have many, but the few I have are annoying. But yes, you do hear that noise, and you can, if a big bug goes in there, you can smell it. So it's like a trade-off. I'm gonna stay with the little guy and see if it's enough that I can go out there and not get bitten. If it doesn't work, then I'm going to go back and put my, it's called Floatron. So if you need the big guy, it's Floatron. They're not expensive, but it's the old razor and the blade thing. They range from about $40 to $70 the units. And the replacement bulbs, which seem to be only made by Floatron, are about $30.
Wow.
Yeah. So, but wow. As I recall, they last about two seasons.
That's perfect. That's great. So, wow, $30 is pretty good.
So, Kevin. Okay, Kevin. Thank you for your video. Kevin, I assume since you said Kentucky, you will get an autographed Mad magazine and an Alfred E. Newman picture. And what I'll probably do, Kevin, is wait a week or so, because soon we'll have the August issue of Mad back from the printers. So we're looking for more videos. I think we have one more video in-house. We're looking for videos that are 2 to 3 minutes long. And, please don't send us really long videos and say, edit this if you like, because we really don't have the time to do that. So it'd be great if you sent us what you think is a good 2 or 3 minutes and send it to mail at.
Oh, here we go. My cue. There we go.
That's your cue. Mail at gizwiz.tv. And like Kevin, it can be a gadget that you knew about from years ago. A gadget that you bought and hated, just a fun gadget that we probably don't know about, and or something that you invented. So it goes to mail at gizwiz.tv. I think we have one more in house. So please make us a video very soon, really soon, because next week we're taping two shows.
Two videos. So there's a good chance you will be on if you send us a good video. Yeah. Perfect.
Excellent.
Well, thank you guys for sending in your videos. And let's move on to the letter.
Here come the letters. I've got the number of the letters. Here come the Giz Wiz letters now. Here come the Giz. I said the Giz Wiz letters.
A letter of the week from William Alford. Hey, Dick and Chad, love the show. Oh, this is for you. Hey, Chad, do you think you can get to the museum in Texas and take pictures and videos for us? Thanks. I love the show, guys. And it is a video game museum.
Oh, exciting.
Video game museum.
The video game history museum.
Museum. Now, I looked, Chad. It's in Frisco, Texas. Do you have any idea where that is?
Yeah, Frisco is like part of Dallas, basically.
Oh, okay. So it's not like hours and hours and hours.
No, Frisco is pretty close to, I think in a lot of places you would call Frisco, Dallas. If I'm remembering correctly, let me make sure that I got this correct. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that it's very north, very, very, very north. Dallas. So,
well, one day, go to the other link too, Chad, which is nvmusa.org.
Perfect.
Because it looked like they had shots of the interior there, and it kind of looks like your kind of thing.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Look at that.
Keep going down, and it seemed like, is that the end of it?
Maybe some.
It looks like they have a museum of every conceivable old.
Look at these. Wow, look at that. Big old Nintendo.
Yeah.
Some arcades.
So one day, if you ever want to make a day trip, look at that.
Wow,
look at this.
A lot of Game Boys. Wow. This is really, 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 really cool.
Oh, that might be a fun thing. They give you doubloons.
Yeah, they give you coins.
Coins. Wow.
Wow, that is really amazing. Yeah, Frisco. I need to make my way up there, Frisco, Texas.
Frisco, Texas. William Michael Alford, thank you for telling us about the national. What is the official name? National Video.
National Video Game History Museum.
Oh, history. I was wondering what the H was. Okay. And they are at nvmusa.org is the one that's in Frisco, Texas.
That is great. Thanks for sending that over. Don't forget to check out the What the Heck Is It game over at gizwiz.biz. Over there on the sidebar, all I have to do is scroll on down to What the Heck Is It. Whoops, I accidentally clicked the Ahoy. Gizmos Ahoy. This is the gadget that you are trying to figure out what the heck it is. I think it's pretty obvious. It's hard to tell scale. You put this on top of trash cans, and it is a fantastic way to make trash can spaghetti. So you put that right on top of round trash cans, those big metal trash cans.
It's like a Fasta Pasta for a party.
Fasta Pasta, yeah, for large metal trash cans. And that'll help just sift it right on out there. You can separate the liquid from the noodles over there at gizwiz.biz. There are 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers if you have the correct idea as to what this gadget is. And then 24 Double the Mad Magazines for hilarious, silly, or ridiculous answers. So get a guessin' over at gizwiz.biz. Next, we want to thank our Patreon supporters. Thank you guys so, so, so much for your support of the Giz Wiz over at patreon.com/gizwiz. Patreon is the place where you can support content creators online with monthly or showly contributions. We have ours set up to do every show, and we thank you guys so, so, so much for your support. Finally, I want to remind you guys, you can vote every single day.
I was just
going
to say, we really have to start the show over, because at the top, we forgot to say...
Go vote!
Welcome to the podcast
nominated show.
Okay, well, we'll do it here.
We have been nominated for the podcast awards, and it would just be so fantastic if we could actually win. You can vote every day. Head on over to the technology section down below. Click our show, The Giz Wiz. And then you just have to type in your name.
Oh, wait, the Giz Wiz is our show?
That is our show. That's us.
Oh,
have you been voting for...
I've been voting for what? I've been voting for What the Tech.
For,
oh, my gosh.
Or the mic.
I'll write in.
The Mouse Castle Lounge. Gosh. So, yeah, please vote for the Giz Wiz. All you have to give them is your name and email, and they just send you a confirmation email. So check your spam folder for that confirmation email. And then choose the Giz Wiz as... obviously, when you're doing that. So thank you. You can do that every single day, and with multiple email addresses. So we encourage you to vote as many times as you can.
And it's not endless. It's not for your entire life. It ends in 10 days, June 12th.
10 days on June 12th, please.
Oh, please. And Chad, someone asked, can you just go in and just vote for the Giz Wiz and not bother with any of the other categories?
You can. You can just only vote for the Giz Wiz if it's the only show that you care about. Okay. So, yes. So, yeah, please do. That would be just fantastic. So, yeah. And we record this show every Thursday. Next week, there is a schedule change. We're recording two shows back to back because the next week I will be gone for E3. So... back-to-back shows next Thursday, starting at 7:30 Eastern Time. 7:30 Eastern Time, that's about 4:30 Pacific Time. And you guys in the middle can just do your own conversions. We'll be doing two shows. You can watch the show live, Giz Wiz.
Wait a second. The second show next week is going to be the special show we talked about, which is going to be our catalog show. So here's your chance to participate. You can win a Mad Magazine if we pick your catalog. So what we're looking for is for you to send in a catalog that we may not know about. And by catalog, I mean a virtual catalog that you find on the web. And when you send it in, say, here's a catalog you might find interesting. It's all about something, something. And here are two things in the catalog that I think is unique.
And what's a good example? Are we saying like Think Geek would be a catalog? But that's one we all know about.
We all know about Think Geek. So so that's kind of why we're depending on you. You know, if you find a catalog, it could be something bizarre. A catalog for a psychic people, and you can buy a psychic cape or
right.
I don't know.
Minecraft website dedicated to Minecraft products. Absolutely.
Something. Gotcha. Okay. So we'll pick like five emails, read them, and then on the show, we'll follow your links, and then we'll look at the unique things, and hopefully it'll be a different kind of show, introducing people to weird catalogs that they might not know have existed. So we're doing that next week as show two, which will be roughly between 8:30 and 9 o'clock.
Perfect.
East Coast time. Okay?
Perfect. So look forward to that. You can find all of our shows if you don't catch one live at gizwiz.tv. There we are live. But if you just scroll down just a little bit, you can subscribe to the show on iTunes, RSS, or YouTube. And you can see all of our old episodes there. So please check them out. You can also find links to our Patreon or our store. We actually have Giz Wiz merchandise available too. We got all sorts of ways for you to support the show. Thanks so much for watching. You do support us just by viewing, so thank you so much.
And when will the crystal jewelry line?
The crystals that we're growing, that line should be available any moment now. In lightsaber red and lightsaber blue. So exciting. I know. Right.
Allow 7 days for your delivery
for shipping and handling. Absolutely.
And handling. Yeah.
Thanks so much for watching the Giz Wiz, and we'll see you next week.
I'll be here.